Here, we will see how to use PI DataLink to build reports based off of event frames with the events explore function that was added to PI DataLink starting with PI DataLink 2014. Event frames, which are also known as events, allow you to mark and track important time periods that represent something happening and impacting your business operations. For example, downtimes, startups, shutdowns, different stages of a process, environmental excursions, these are all events. With the PI system, you can track them so they have a name, a start time, an end time, and capture any related information that is useful for analysis. Event frames are not set up in PI DataLink, but PI DataLink can be used as a visualization tool. Here I'm looking at a spreadsheet in Excel that is used to look at downtime events for a packaging company. And this uses the explore option in PI DataLink and makes it really easy to see for the specified time period what were some of the main reasons for the downtimes, which pieces of equipment were more likely to be affected. And I get a list of, which is populating these charts, of all the different downtime events that were experienced, and it makes it really easy to see how individual downtime events really impacted the overall line average production. Let's take a look at how we can build such a report. As you build a report based off of event frames in Excel using PI DataLink, the first question that you're going to need to ask is, which time period should we search for events? In this case, I am going to be using cell references to keep my spreadsheet as robust as possible so I can just make changes really easily. And I'm going to be using this search criteria going from a start time of an hour ago to an end time of now using these PI time references. Other thing I'll need to do is I'll just go ahead and decide where I'm going to output my event list to, and I'll select B5 before I go ahead and hit explore. This brings up the menu on the right, and for the search start, I could specify that here, but if I want to use the cell references, I'll clear this out, make sure my cursor is selected, and then pick the specific cell that matches the start time that I'm interested in. So this one, C2. And you can see that this is just adding C2 to the search start in an Excel format. I'll do the same thing for the search end, clear this out, have my cursor here, and then select the end time that I'm interested in. I'll leave everything else as is, and you'll notice that that first cell I selected, B5, automatically gets added as the output cell. So wherever you click before you click the explore function, the same with all the other PI DataLink functions, that's going to by default be the output cell. Though if you need to change it, just change it right here. I'm good with this output, so I'll go ahead and hit OK. And as you can see, this has brought in a list of events that fit that time criteria. As I look at these events, you can see some of these don't have an end time and duration reported back. And this depends on, did the event frame ever end? In this case, these events are still active, though you can see that they started a long time ago. This equipment has clearly been down for a long time. So if you want to filter how the events are reported for that time period, we can do the search mode. For instance, if I only want to look at events that entirely were in the last hour, that's a choice I can make. To bring up the options again, I'm just going to click on the array with a left click, and if you've got the pop-up enabled, you'll see that here. And under more search options, right here, I'll expand this, and you can see the particular way that I would modify this is using the search mode. And I can indeed do a cell reference for that. Right now, I'm just going to do entirely in range and hit OK. So you can see that that has now reduced our event list and now all have an end time and duration as expected. So this is returning all the events that occurred during the time period. The next question that you need to start asking yourself is, well, what type of events should we return? I want to say focus on the equipment downtime events, and I can do additional filtering off of the event name and event template. So let me go ahead and build some cell references for that. So for the event name, I know that there's equipment in the name for the equipment downtime, so I'll use star equipment star, some wildcards to get that. And then for the event template, that's my downtime for the event template. And let me go ahead and once again filter down further. So for the event name, add that cell reference, and I'll click on this option, this icon right here for event template, and then I'm going to select event template. Okay, so these are the events that I'm focusing on. You may want to restrict your event list even further, say by specific types of assets, or even an attribute that you're particularly interested in looking at. So for an example, let me go ahead and concentrate on a specific piece of equipment that's having a downtime due to a very specific fault code. And you can see that the fault codes for the different downtime events, some examples of what could be causing it, are listed here in the previous event list that we returned. So I'm going to focus on the box packer, bring up the options again. So the element name, actually, I have that built off of the template. So I'll select that. And then the really exciting thing is I can do even more filtering off of the attributes using these attribute value filters. I'm going to look at all the ones where the fault code equals, let's do product misfeeds. And I'll need to select an operator as well. And that's equals. And I'll go ahead and hit OK. And you can see that I've only returned one event. And this is because there has only been one downtime event for a box packer due to a product misfeeds. Now, all this time we've been focusing on determining which events are we going to bring in. We've looked at for what time period, what type of event, which assets, even for which assets that have a particular attribute value. The final consideration is really, what do we want to show in the event list that gets reported here, and how do we want that information to be presented? Let me switch back to looking at all the different pieces of equipment rather than just the box packer, which is an easy switch with my cell reference here. And if you see this resize to show all values, you'll just need to do a right click and do recalculate resize function. Okay, and I have the explore events options back up here, and this very last section. And these are the columns that are selecting which information about the event we want to present. By default, this list is going to include the virtual attributes that are generated for all events, things like the start time, end time, as well as all of the event frame template attributes. So let me make some selections here. The event name is not something that I'm particularly interested in showing because I'm going to be including the primary element. That's the element that's affected, so I'll move that up. The start time and duration, and the event template. So that will represent that it's a downtime for me. And I'm going to look to see if there's anything else I want to show. I'm going to not want to show the status either. And these are just all selections that you can make for which columns to display. And if you want the columns to be sorted in a particular way, that's something that you can choose. For more search options, there's the start order, and in this case, mine are being ordered with start time ascending. Again, this is another option that can be changed. So I'll go ahead and hit OK, and look at how the columns now represent my choices. As you can see, there's a lot of great functionality for building these specific reports that help you track or report off your events using the PI DataLink's Explore function. And you may be wondering to yourself, we've been spending all this time focusing on Explore, when would it make sense to use Compare? And the difference between Explore and Compare really comes down to, do you have child event frames? If you don't have child event frames, just use Explore. And in the next video, we're going to be looking at use cases where there are child events and the differences between using Explore and Compare.